Alright folks, it's Stardrop here, returning for more Final Fantasy X-2. We're in the Creature Creator, trying to build our ultimate dream team to overcome the Major Numerus. I mean, I can already beat him, but I want to beat him faster. So, yeah. Okay, last time I think I explained that we are trying to look for these three Machina dudes. Namely, Machina Leader, Hunter, and Ranger. We caught a Soldier, but that's not the one we want. So let's keep on keeping on. Let's fight some more tournaments to get more Trap Pods. Okay. If you're watching this video as kind of a guide, you can. And if you want to, you can just skip all of my farming, because I'm going to keep all of this stuff on screen while I just talk about random stuff. So that's kind of my plan right now. If you're not interested in that stuff, just scroll along in the video until, you know, I'm done with my farming and we can just catch some Machina dudes. Otherwise, just keep watching, yeah? So last time I fought the Fark Plane Cup and I had to fight against Tremor, that was like super not fun, so I'm not gonna do that again. We fought the Youth League Cup once, but let's go and fight the Aeon Cup again. I don't remember what kind of rewards you can get from this, but I know it's like super easy with Shinra on my team. Alright. Yo, Jimbo's first. Oh man, it's been so long since I had anything to do with the Aeons. So cool.
Prepare to meet your doom.
There's that dog, Kojiro, I think it's called. Was it? Oh, you can't even target the dog. Alright, your Jimbo should be dead. Actually, I think all of these guys will die in one hit from Shinra. Yeah, I don't see any of them surviving one Cleon. The thing does like 500,000 damage.
Try again in another 1,000 years.
I love Shinra's battle quotes. So good. Try again in another 1,000 years. Oh, large pod? No. Either small or SP pods are what I need. Okay, so there's Ixion. Alright guys, so what was I going to talk about? I had something planned, but I no longer remember. Wow, that just did 10,000 damage?
I've just been toying with you up to now.
Good job, Ixion. Damn. This will again be in my 10-2 playlist, so it will be there. Like, if you haven't, whoops, I dropped my pen from my desk. I keep doing that because, you know, I keep knocking it off. Yeah, if you're watching this video before you finish the 10-2 completion guide, I suggest you watch that first. Even if you're not like playing the game for 100%, just watch it, so you won't be like completely confused of what I'm doing here, although I don't think it matters too much anyways. So what I'm doing right now is, yeah, fighting different tournaments to get pods so I can catch stuff. I'll need a couple of either small pods or SP pods to continue. Yeah, so this is going up on my original 10-2 playlist so people can find it easier. It'll be like, because this is what YouTube calls an official playlist, all of the videos will be recommended on the side, even if they have like nothing to do with each other. But because these videos all have like the same titles, basically, you know, Final Fantasy X-2 in the title, they are not only related, but they're also part of the official playlist, which means you'll be able to find these even if you're not subscribed, which, by the way, you should not be. You should totally be subscribed. It's just cooler that way. Yeah, just saying. I did not get a single trap pod there. Wow, that was such a bitter disappointment. Okay, here's what I'm gonna do, guys. I'm gonna fight the Far Plane, if I can speak properly. I'm gonna fight the Far Plane Cup. But every time I encounter Tremor, I'm just gonna run away. That's the plan. I'm not sitting there for 5 to 10 minutes fighting Tremor. It's just not happening. Oh, there's Major Numerus. Oh boy. Well, at least either Tremor or Major Numerus, I don't have to fight both. That's good. Okay, so what are we doing first? Oh, this guy. Conjurer, I think his name? Yes, sir. Conjurer.
I've just been toying with you up to now.
Yeah, Yuna doesn't have like auto break damage limit, so this Moogle Beam is only gonna do 10k. If he doesn't die right now. Okay, he doesn't die. But Yuna is using the higher power garment grid, which gives us break damage limit if we pass through one of the gates. It's way too lazy to do on like such a like insignificant enemy. Yeah, so only gonna do 10k. It would be the green gate I have to pass through to get break damage limit. Okay, so I'm just gonna get a chain on that Cleon here. There you go. And Conjurer is dead. The only reason Conjurer is like any kind of enemy at all is because he can use this thing called Megaton Press. And that does a crap ton of damage. Like, you don't even understand. It does so much.
No problem.
And there's Paragon. Cool. Let's see. Is there anything cool I can use on Paragon? Delay Buster. I don't know
I've
why.
I've just been toying with you up to now.
Just want to use it for no particular reason. Man, I miss farming Paragon for, like, money and dark matters. It was fun. Oh, he's dead already? Wow. Well, so much for that. So much for Mr. Paragon. And there we have the standard Omega weapon type death. Oh, by the way, if you don't know how I got like Shinra's stats so high, is I kept on feeding him Iron Dukes. And Iron Dukes, every time you use one, it increases the amount of HP. The stats he gets by 10, so every single stat. And not only that, you get a little bit of HP. And he can increase his HP by equipping accessories that boost HP. And you can also buy these things called Titanium Bengals down in the Mihen High Road Agency. And those will boost your HP as well. Oh, wait a minute. Why am I fighting him? Damn it. Oh, whatever. Let's just fight him. Since I've already started. If Yuna doesn't die, this should be okay.
Prepare to meet your doom.
Okay. Wow, I just fought this guy last episode. Can't believe I'm doing it again. Not very cool. Come on, Yuna. Don't die. Don't die. Damn it. Okay, I'm running away. That's just... No. Not happening. I'm not gonna waste everyone's time. I've had enough. Okay, you know what? How about this? We'll give Yuna one last chance to use Miracle Drink. If she can't do it, I'm running. Because Major Numerous is just like so relentless with his attacks. Alright, come on. Mortis Command. I'm pretty sure Yuna's dead. Okay. That's it. I'm done. I am done. I'm done, man. Don't even. Just don't even, Shinra. Like, get out.
I've just been toying with you up to now.
I mean, I could fight him again, but it's gonna take so damn long. Run away! Yeah, there you go. Tournament lost. Oh, but I still get a trap pod. Nice. Oh, that's still worth it. Cool. And yeah, the alien wins the tournament. Whatever, man. Have your victory. I'll be back for you once I build my perfect team. Okay, let's do it again. Farplane Cup. Probably just last time. And then I'll go capture some stuff. Okay. No way. I'm fighting him on the first... Come on, Yuna. Do your magic. Miracle drink, miracle drink. Mix, potion, dark matter, go!
I've just been toying with you up to now.
Cleon does just so much damage. I think like Numerous has almost no defense at all. That's why it's doing 60,000 damage on the final chains. Quite impressive. Oh no! No, no! Oh, that's not gonna save her. What am I doing? Alright, I'm out. I can't believe I have to... Raddus Command. That attack does so much damage. Like, if I'm at 5 stars, that thing does like 40-something thousand. It's crazy. Or 30-something, I don't know.
I've just been toying with you up to now.
Nope. Nope. Get out, Shinra. Get out. Like, get out now. I don't need this. I don't need this grief. Okay. If it isn't already, like, abundantly clear, you can escape from a fight by reducing your stars to 0. Nice! Another Trap Pod S! Sweet! Okay. One last time. I promise. So, far plane. Let's go. I find it cool that all of these tournaments are like happening inside Shinra's spaceship, or I guess it would be Buddy's spaceship. Like, it's happening inside, I don't know, the core of the spaceship or something. It's really interesting. That's why when you're doing the Fiend Portal and you have to fight Almighty Shinra, if you lose, Shinra actually destroys the entire ship. It's actually kind of interesting, and you can get a game over. That's literally the only time you can get a game over in Creature Creator.
Prepare to meet your doom.
So Orin is a semi-challenging fight if you don't have really powerful creatures, because he likes to use Shooting Star, which has the Eject special ability. Eject just completely banishes you from the fight. Ribbon does not even work on it. However, status, that ailment defense that Shinra has, that works on it, so you can defend against Eject that way. Oh, what the heck?
I think I'll give this fighting thing a try.
Well, third time's a charm, right? Let's do it. Nope. Never mind. Okay. Yeah, I'm done. I'm gonna go back out to Trap Creature and see if I can get some more Machina dudes.
Prepare to meet your doom.
Man. The weather outside where I live right now is totally taunting me. The weather is so good. I should not be sitting inside playing games, but alas, here I am. It's like a crisp 15 degrees outside. Well, 15 Celsius. Definitely not Fahrenheit. Which is amazing. Sorry, I can't do the conversion to you. I'm not Imperial. I'm full metric system. Like, I live in Canada, and a lot of our measurements are in metric, but we also use some of the Imperial because the Americans affect us. So our height, for example, we don't say like, yo, I'm 180 centimeters, no, or 1.8 meters. We still say, yeah, I'm 5'11", or I'm 6 feet tall. So it's weird for people to use the metric system there, which I'm actually kind of disappointed, because if you're going to stick with one measurement system, like the metric system, just stick with it for everything. Don't be swayed by how other countries do it. I'm pretty sure the United States is like the only country that uses the imperial system, which is kind of dumb. You need to like start educating your kids to start using the metric system, man, seriously. Okay, so let's go back out to Trap Creature. Going off on like a slight rant there. But no, I could talk for hours about how the Imperial system sucks, but I won't do it. Alright, Trap Creature. Okay, how many small pods do I have? Ooh, nice! I have a bunch of small pods and one SP pod, so let's start doing this. Last I checked, it was the Thunder Plains where I can get one of the ones I need, so let's use a small pod there and see what I get. There we go, Machina Leader. Cool. Let's take him. He only has one arm. But don't let that fool ya. The dude's good. Okay, so next I'm going to go to the Mihen High Road. Oh, sorry. I gotta go back. This gets me every time. You have to go back to the Trap Creature screen. So let's go to Mihen High Road and target Machina again. And hopefully I can get either Hunter or the other one's Ranger. So let's see what I get. Machina Ranger. Perfect. So I'm going to keep that. me and Iroh. Keep in mind that if you don't get what you need, you can keep it. And the next time you use a pod in that same place, the chances will be higher that you'll get what you want, because you cannot have two of the same creatures. Otherwise, I'll just use 3 liters, you know? Okay, so I don't quite remember where the last one was. Let me see, it was, okay, so me and Hyrule, Thunder Plains. Just 1 second, folks, let me look it up. Yeah. If you're hearing that beeping sound, that's just me switching displays, because I play my PS3 on the same monitor as my PC. So I'm just switching my display from the PS3 to my actual computer. Okay, so which ones do I have? I just got the leader and I have the ranger, right? Which means the one I need is Hunter, which I can get from Luca. Okay, perfect. Switch back. Okay. So, let's go to Luca then. There it is. See, got me again. Every time. And I totally didn't mean to do that. Trap creature. So again, if you're wondering why I'm choosing these three particular machinas, it's because they learn an ability called Impale, which is a really quick attack that pierces defense. Luca. What do I got? Ew, what is that? I guess I'll take ya. Oh. Well, I don't need a soldier, so let's just replace a soldier. Okay, let's go back and try it again. If worse comes to worse, I can always release Seymour. I want to keep Tidus and Oren though, just for fun. Or Oren because he's just cool. And what the hell? Is that like the same thing I just... Alright, try it again. Yeah, Oren because he's just so badass, and Tidus because he's like the main character of 10 and all. Yeah. Do it again. What the heck? Death Dauber. No. One more time. Actually, folks, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go save my game, and if I don't get it within these next 3 small pods, I'll just load. I don't want to fight more tournaments. Yeah. And also, if I don't get it, I'll just like do some editing stuff here and there. All right. So this is the first time I'm saving my game in quite a while. I didn't save my game between my last video and now. So yeah, you can see my last save was May 12th, 2014. Yeah. Alright. I'm not going to overwrite. Let's just pick a new data. Okay. Go back. I'm not going to do any kind of playing around in the real world in 10-2. It's going to be like completely focused on creature creator, which you should know by now. If you don't, and or if you don't like it, tough luck. That's what we're dealing with. All right, Luca. Come on. Wow. Blueberry pudding. Nope. Don't want. Please don't make me do any editing. Just like, give me that stupid thing. Shigoon. Wow. Nope. Last one. I guess it would be so much easier if I can just get an SP pod, because I'm fairly certain this last Machina is the only Machina species you can find in Luca. But I don't really know. It's empty! What?! You've gotta be kidding me! Yeah, I think I'm gonna go ahead and do that. I'm gonna get another SP pod. And yeah, I'll just Oh, that's right, he does give you a small one. Okay, so I don't have to load. I can just keep on using this small one. On Luca. Yeah, cool. Right, if you completely run out of pods, Shinra actually gives you one. Nope, I don't want your white elemental. We just have to like exit out to the creature creator every time. Oh, sometimes he gives you mediums? Can he give me an SP? Alright, let's just use this medium anywhere. Volcano! No, go away. Nobody likes you. I think that particular enemy, the bomb, was in like all of the Final Fantasy games. At least in quite a few of them. They're almost iconic, like the Chocobo. Yeah. Maybe not like exactly what they look like there, but something similar. Wow, maybe I should just go get an SP pod. This is, there are quite a nice variety of things you can catch in Luca. Wow. Oh, by the way, if you see there, top right corner, creatures completed, 98%. I had dreams of getting 100%, but it's so tedious. I literally don't even know how to get that last 2%. But I remember a while ago, I literally sat here for like 2 days just trying to complete all of the Fiend Tales. You have no idea how long it took. Well, I suppose you do if you did it, but why would you? Seriously. Nobody should oh, there we go. Okay. Nobody should subject themselves to doing 100% creature completed thing for Shinra's for this bestiary thing. It's just far too tedious. Okay, so that's that. Nice. Very nice. We got all three of our little things. Alright. Let me just take a look at these guys. So, in creature, we got Machina Hunter, Leader, Ranger. Yep, as you can see, they all have Impale. And they all have Ailment Defense and Lightning Eater, which I don't care for. I'm going to quickly level these guys up a little bit. Oh, no, never mind. They're already level 99. Okay, that saved me a little bit of work. So what I'm going to do then is, here's how you do this. So you go into creature here, select one of them. I'm going to go ahead and unlearn their attack ability. Why can't I unlearn Cure, I wonder? Let me find out why. Okay, so equip. Is it because... That's actually weird. Let's see. Unlearn. I can unlearn Lightning Eater, no problem. Like, that's bad anyways. I'm definitely not gonna unlearn Impale. So I guess Cure just is here to stay. That's interesting. Okay, fine. But I'm definitely gonna unlearn attack because Impale does basically the same thing except it pierces defense. So. Okay. Do all three of those guys. Okay, so all they're gonna know now is Cure and Impale. I'm gonna take one of them for a test drive just to see how he performs. But first, I am going to make it so that he has better stats. Okay, as I said, I think it was this time or last time, Iron Dukes increase each of your stats by 1. So I'm going to take my Hunter here and give it a bunch of Iron Dukes. Okay, I have 28 Iron Dukes right now, so I'm just going to, you know, feed him a bunch of this. You can get 5 Iron Dukes per rare drop from each of Major Numerous's heads. And because Major Numerous has 4 heads, you can get up to 20 Iron Dukes per fight. The only problem is it's a rare drop, right? It's like a 5% drop chance. You can always boost it up to 100% by equipping the Ray of Hope Garment Grid on one of your creatures. That gives you the passive ability called Butterfingers, which guarantees a rare drop every single time. That's really nice. Okay, so I'm just going to keep going with my Iron Dukes and boost every single stat to maximum. There we go. 244 luck, whatever. Not going to waste another Iron Duke for that. So other than that, let's give it a couple of abilities. So one of the most important thing you have to give your creatures is break damage limit. And this is important because obviously you want your attacks to do more than 10,000 damage per hit. If you're only doing 10,000, you know, like, that's just not good. To get break damage limit, obviously you use the invincible. I have 17 invincibles. You can get these by fighting numerous, as long as you don't have the rare drop thing equipped. He will drop a lot of invincibles. You can also get it, I believe, from the Farkplane Club. Yes, club. Okay. Invincible. Let's go ahead and do that. We also want break HP limit. He only has 4,700 HP right now, but eventually we want that HP to go a little bit higher, so give him an Enterprise, which is a drop, I believe, exclusively from Numerous, and you'll get break HP limit. So I also want him to have auto haste because Impale is like a basic attack, so he doesn't have to charge up with a purple bar, which means that you can use Impale whenever, even like if an enemy is already using an action, which is really, really good. Obviously it helps if you can move faster towards the enemies, which is why we want haste. Haste doesn't boost the amount of, the speed of which your ATB bar charges, but it does make your things move faster. The way we get haste is by giving him 3 chocobo wings. Wait a minute. Oh, it's a casting skill. Hold on, let me see. Is that it? Huh, I guess Chocobo Wings give you the haste guy. It's not a particularly great ability. Let me see if I have any speed bracers. I think that one also gave you haste. I have 8 speed bracers, awesome. So that will give me auto haste. That's even better. 3 speed bracers though. Darn. do I want to do it? Why not? I don't remember quite how to get speed bracers. I'll find out eventually. Okay, so as far as auto abilities go, that should be everything. We can only teach them 4 anyway, so that's good. Main commands. Let me think about which ones would be good. All I need is Impale. I'm just thinking out loud now, so will probably help if I get Vigor. That will let him heal when he gets hurt, so let's see. Vigor was Turbo Ethers. There you go. I have no idea why Ethers are supposed to teach a creature how to heal his HP, but whatever. Yeah. I think that should be good. Yeah. So other than that, let's just equip this guy a little bit with some good garment grids. Obviously, first steps is bad. I'm gonna go for the... Where is it? The one that gives me critical. There it is, Peerless. So now he'll always crit, and I'm gonna give him the mascot dress gear just so that he also gets some ribbon, but it doesn't really matter. So to boost his HP a little bit more, we can give him more Iron Dukes. Each Iron Duke will double his HP. Key to Success will do the same thing if your stats are already maxed. So yeah, let's just go ahead and do that. 14,000 HP. Not bad, my friend, my Machina Hunter. So 14,000 though, it's still not terrific. We're going to boost it a little bit more right now. So the way to boost a creature's HP is, let's just talk to, this is one of those rare occasions where I'm going to go out into the real world. I won't be doing this very often. We're going to go to the Machalania Agency. Okay, so where is it? Machalania? Wait. It could have been the Meehan Agency. Let's just go there. It's one of those agencies. We'll explore a little bit. If it's not this one, I'll go to the other one. I'm going to buy an item called Titanium Bangle. That will boost our HP. Okay, nice. So I'm gonna talk to Mrs. Albed over here and ride a hover to the agency. Haven't seen this in so long. Riding the hover. Alright. So I'm here. Let's go ahead and get into the agency. Some people have said that on the Vita and on the PS4, the loading screens are a lot shorter, and I believe them. On my PS3, it's just so slow, man. Okay, I chose the right place. Titanium Bangle. Let's just get as many as I can. There we go. Alright, Machina, you're gonna eat some titanium, whether you like it or not. Force feeding time. Ready? There he is. So each one gives him 66 HP, and yes, you do have to... Wait, is there a way to make him to give more? Or is this like the only way? Oh, I love how it defaults to no, so it's like you have to press up on the... Why, game? Why? Wait, I was giving him the wrong bangle. oh! Cool, Mithril Bangle gives him even more, but I don't think you can, Mithril and Crystal, I don't think you can buy these. So however many you have is however many you get to work with. I guess I'll just use them all, it's not like I'll need it for anything else. Sorry if this is tedious, but yeah. I should do some video editing, but I'm just lazy like that, so I'm not gonna do it. In the meantime, though, let's talk some other stuff. What is there to talk about? I think I already mentioned that the weather is really nice outside, and I want to go outside. Which is probably what I'm going to do after I do this. But for now, it's Final Fantasy X-2 time. I just had a really big urge to play Final Fantasy X-2, and that's why I decided to make these videos again. Alright, almost done. Yeah, because this game has always had a really special place in my heart. It's not my favorite Final Fantasy game, but it's definitely the Final Fantasy game with my favorite battle system. So I really like coming back to it once in a while. Although, you know what's funny though? In this game, the battle system is like it's like a real-time ATB, right? But as you get to endgame, as in where I am right now, and all your creatures have maxed out agility, it almost becomes a turn-based game because you're just sitting on the you're just sitting on the purple ATB bar charge up most of the time, because only one character's purple ATB skill can launch on screen at a time, and if more than one character have it charged up completely, then the game will just execute them in sequence with delays in between. I feel like if the game just like allowed multiple skills to be active at once on the screen, the game will be a lot faster. And it would have been a lot more interesting to play. But they didn't do that for some reason. Which is kind of a disappointment. The game's battle system would go from like great to amazing. If that were the case. I think 30,000 HP is good. Let's just not spam anymore after 30,000. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Alright, let's just take a few more for the road, and we'll be out to test this guy. Of course, my ultimate goal is to have three of these dudes, but for now, let's just use one and see what happens. Actually, what's Yuna wearing? Sprint shoes, okay, that's good. Hunter, Oh look, he lost his cure. I wonder why that is. What gave him the cure to begin with? Okay, that's weird. Okay. Let's take a look at my other ones. Yeah, this guy still has it. Is it just because he's not wearing any dress fear? Maybe if you're not wearing any dress fear, you get cure. That could be it, yeah. Let's see. I only have 3 Iron Dukes left. Damn it, I need more. Yeah, let's go back to the airship. Back to the airship. Okay, what I'm going to do right now is to take this dude along with Yuna to fight Major Numerous Ones just to see how much damage I can do. I'm not obviously going to win, you know, unless my miracle drink somehow goes off. But yeah, if I just want to see how much he can do. And then we get a good idea of how much 3 of them can do. Let's see, Battle Simulator. Outer Plane Envoy. Oh, it would help to put him on my team first. Party members, okay. Let's put the Hunter in over Shinra. And yeah. Okay. Folks, here we go. Okay, obviously, ooh, 29k. Look at that. Impale 27k, doing pretty well. And I'm not even on 5 stars. I can already see like how this is, would be so much better than having Shinra around. Well, Yuna died. Honestly, my little guy can just like... No, he's definitely not going to win alone. Let's go 5 stars. 42k! And he's just taking a beating. Yeah. You can see how fast he's moving too. Alright, he just healed himself. It's kind of cool. Okay. I might actually... I'm just trying to think right now how I can farm for more Iron Dukes so that I can raise more of these dudes. Because obviously this guy can't do it by himself. Like, his damage is fantastic for just one character. Just going at it with the Impale. But he can't do it alone. If Yuna were still alive to give him a miracle drink, then obviously. Or, alternatively, what I can do is I can give him the Last Resort Garment Grid. He obviously won't have the critical hit anymore, but he will have the Hero Drink ability. And Hero Drink is the same as a Miracle Drink, except it only gives it to one character. So that could be a possibility. Okay. He just keeps healing. I love it. He's like invincible. Okay, I'm gonna quit out of this. It's kind of pointless. Alright. So, it was good. My research has paid off. This guy can do pretty good damage. So, all that's left is trying to get more Iron Dukes somehow. Let me try something here. I'm going to put Shinra into my roster, along with Makina Hunter, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to equip this guy with, instead of Peerless, we're going to do the Ray of Hope. Where is it? There we go. As I said, the Ray of Hope comes with a Butterfinger ability, which makes it so that enemies will always drop their rare drop. The only drawback to equipping this is that you get the ability card Dismissal, which, like, it's a good ability, except it's like a charge-up ability, so you can't use it very quickly. But we'll see. Maybe he won't use it too often. If I can beat this guy in like a fair amount of time, then it'll be nice. Yeah, you can see. You see this? He's already like spamming Dismissal, which I don't want him to do.
I've just been toying with you up to now.
The Impale is where it's at. Yeah, it feels kind of strange though, without having a character that I can control. It's like Final Fantasy 13 all over again. It gives you the illusion of control. But there's no control. Darn it. So without Peerless, without auto crit, we're doing only half damage. So instead of 40 something thousand, we can only do 20 something thousand per hit. Shinra is here to make up for it, obviously. Because Shinra is just so badass with that Cleon. I really wish that he wouldn't use Dismissal.
I've just been toying with you up to now.
It's like the game is mocking me. Be like, you see, you got Dismissal equipped. I'm just gonna spam it all over and over again. Because why use a stronger skill when I can use a weaker skill, right? God damn it. Okay, I'm fairly certain that I can win though. Numerous has got nothing on me. And this is probably the way I'm going to do it to like farm for my Iron Dukes. I'm just gonna use this setup. And once I have a good number of I only have to beat him three times like this, and then I'll have all the Iron Dukes I need to max out all of my three little Machinas. Once I do, then they will be like awesome.
I've just been toying with you up to now.
You see how much faster that impale is than Dismissal? It's ridiculous. Okay, nice. That strongest hit there hit for over 60,000. Foaming Command. Oh, which reminds me, I should give my Machina Hunter a Force of Nature so that he can absorb those attacks. Dismissal! What a loser. Stop it. Stop it with your dismissal. Just like stop it. Ooh! I learned electrocute.
I've just been toying with you up to now.
Yeah, creatures can learn random abilities like in battle depending on the situation. So I think what happened is the Machina Hunter got hit by an electric attack, so he learned electrocute. They put a lot of work in the creature creator when it comes to just like learning random abilities. Too bad these random abilities are like never like spectacular. Except for the Chocobo's one. The Chocobo can learn haste all by himself. And that's what makes him amazing. Okay. Electrocute! Did that do anything? Like, is it just gonna... What? Like, he's just gonna do nothing? Okay then. I guess the electrocute does nothing.
I've just been toying with you up to now.
Alright, Shinra. You're up. Yeah, see? How he took the impale there while Shinra is using Leon? It's awesome. Okay, let's just finish this guy already. Damage dismissal, not terrible, but it needs to like charge up and everything, and that's just meh. You know what would have been amazing if Shinra was like a small creature. Oh, that would be so overpowered. I'm surprised Shinra is not like a large creature that takes three slots. He's just that good. He's a medium, which just is like mind-boggling. He can use a controllable character alongside of him.
Prepare to meet your doom.
Okay, one of the heads died, which means the other three won't be far along. Oh, there's the second head. Electrocute. Zero. Oh, it does something, but it's just zero. I see. Oh wait, two heads died. Alright, just one left then.
Prepare to meet your doom!
Alright, that's it. Okay, So already this guy is looking pretty promising. I have to find a way for him to not use electrocute. And obviously, if I want the rare drops from Major Numerous, I have to equip the dismissal. There's no choice. Yeah, 20 Iron Dukes, nice. Cool. Okay, so I think I'm gonna end off the video here. Next time I come back, I'll do a bit more farming. I don't know if I should do it on screen or not. Wow, I just like talk about random stuff, maybe. But I'm gonna end off this episode here. Leave a comment, whatever, talk to me. I always like it when people comment on my videos because it gives me a chance to interact with my viewers. You know, it's really nice to get to know people. And I am almost there as to building my team of ultimate Major Numerous killing creatures. So that's kind of cool. Anyways, let's not drag this out any further. I'll probably do another video tomorrow. So yeah, stay tuned guys. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.